Hey, it's AI Gamer here, where I teach you to code by building AIs to play video games. This is my series on Teamfight Tactics, which is an auto-battler built by Riot Games for mobile and PC. Although it has some randomness, it also has a lot of strategy, which makes it a good fit for an AI. This video will give a general overview of my goals for this project and show step-by-step how I'm building it. Here's my process. First, brainstorm projects. There are a ton of awesome games, but I have to focus on just one. Two, risk management. I need to plan ahead to avoid potential roadblocks. 3. Define architecture. There are too many possible technologies, I need to narrow it down. 4. Proof of concept. Before I code advanced features, I need to get the basics working. 5. Incremental improvement. Rome wasn't built in a day, and my AI won't be either. My first step was brainstorming what type of project to build. Since I'm a coder and a gamer, building a gaming AI sounded like a fun project. Most of my professional coding experience is with business applications, so this will be a nice change of pace. My main criteria for picking a game was something with strategy and something I'm passionate about. Although League of Legends is my favorite game, it's team-based and very mechanical, both of which makes it extremely challenging for an AI to handle. I'd love to try it someday, but I want to start with an easier project first. I ranked Plat and TFT last year, so I already know how to play it, and I'd love to see if I can rank higher, so it seems like a perfect fit. Now, just to clarify, I'm doing this project for fun, and I have no intention of ruining the gamer community. I won't release my bot for others to use, and I won't ruin people's games. Since TFT is a last man standing game, I won't be hurting any teammates if my bots play poorly. I'm also not trying to create any exploits like infinite lives. I want the AI to replicate human behavior as closely as possible. My next step was risk management. I don't want to start a project that I'm not confident I can accomplish. I also don't have a budget, so I need to verify that there are plenty of open source tools and libraries I can leverage. It needs to be a project I'm passionate about, so I don't lose interest, and also small enough that I can accomplish it on my own without help and without getting stuck or burned out. I think a TFT bot matches all these criteria. Determining scope is very important. For version 1, my goals are, first, automate UI. I want it to be able to play the entire game without any human interaction. 2. Code basic strategy. I want to verify that it's making semi-intelligent decisions, not just completely random choices. And third, I want to win a single unranked first place game. This is my initial criteria to say my basic AI is working. This probably sounds too simple, but it's better to start with a basic proof of concept and make improvements over time. It's fun to daydream about a perfect product with every possible feature. However, if my initial project is too difficult, it'll never get finished. In the real world, at some point, a project has to be labeled completed, so it can be shipped to customers, despite its flaws. There's always room for improvements in version 2. Before I can start coding, I need to architect the software. It's too hard to visualize a project as a whole, so I need to break it down into smaller tasks. Then I can document the high-level requirements of each one and evaluate any potential risks that would prevent me from completing them. For this project, I think the main problems to solve are, first, gather data. The AI doesn't have eyes. It needs a way to understand what's happening during the game. 2. Train. AIs aren't magic. They need to learn, or be taught, the strategy in order to play the game. 3. Act. The bot needs to simulate the user input as if it were a human. These are still too big to actually start coding, so later on I'll break them down into even smaller pieces. The concept of gathering in-game data sounds relatively simple. At the most basic level, the AI needs to know what cards I have in my hand and which units are on the board so it can make decisions. This is actually a bit trickier than it sounds. The easiest way would be to read the internal memory of the program while it's running. The risk here is that I know Riot has coded anti-cheat mechanisms to try to prevent this. Because TFT has a PC, Mac, and mobile version, I think I can get it to work on at least one of these platforms. If I choose to attempt this method, I should first test if it works before I get too far down that rabbit hole. One way is using an app called Cheat Engine. It can also change memory for hacking things like infinite lives, but it will only be reading memory. If I wanted to cheat, exploits that modify process memory usually don't work in online games since the majority of the logic is actually run on the server, not on my local PC. If Cheat Engine fails, my homegrown code will also, so I should test that first before I waste time coding it. It may also be possible to bypass these protections by running the app through an emulator or virtual machine to circumvent these protections. Another option is to use computer vision techniques. These can analyze the graphics being displayed on the screen. For simple graphics like icons and text, this is pretty easy. But for 3D models with animations, this is actually very difficult. For some games, like first-person shooters, the 3D graphics and animations give crucial info to the user about where to move and how to aim. Since TFT is basically a card game, I think the simple text and icons will give me most of the information I need. I can probably ignore the fancy graphics as pure eye candy. Once I'm ready to code this task, I'll determine which approach to use. For now, it's enough to simply recognize that I have multiple options, so I'm not concerned about failing. The heart of this coding project will be building the AI. Strategy games intentionally give you multiple compelling choices, so you have to make a gut decision. Unfortunately, computers were designed as calculators, which follow precise instructions. They can't naturally judge a decision by weighing pros and cons, or learn from their experiences or mistakes. This makes beating a strategy game difficult with traditional coding methods. Luckily, multiple types of AI techniques have been invented, which attempt to make computers more flexible in their decision-making. For example, neural networks, fuzzy logic, heuristics, and genetic algorithms. These strategies are each very different and have their own unique strengths and weaknesses, so I'll need to be smart about how I utilize them. Neural networks and genetic algorithms are self-learning. This would be ideal for TFT, but the difficulty is that they require a large amount of training data. Depending on the complexity of the problem to solve, it may require thousands or millions of examples. The issue is that TFT does not have a very good match history. It only shows the player's final units, not their actions chosen each round. It also doesn't show the unit's positioning on the grid. TFT also doesn't support spectating other people's games, so gathering training data will be difficult. Fuzzy logic allows the computer to make these types of decisions. The problem is, fuzzy logic requires hard-coded rules, so they don't allow the AI to learn new strategies. This can work for simple strategies, but not very complex ones. I think the lack of training data will be a significant risk to this task, so I may need to find workarounds for that. However, I think the AI will still work fine, it just might not learn to be as smart as I prefer. I think simulating mouse and keyboard input to remote control the app should be fairly easy. The only complexity is that each operating system and device are slightly different. Ideally, I should decide which platform I'm gaming on as early as possible, so I can avoid rewriting any code. However, if I use an open source library that is cross-platform, it should alleviate some of that risk. Another risk is that Riot Games has put significant effort into prevent cheating. I want to code my bot in a way that's not easily detectable to prevent my account from getting banned. For that reason, I may need to act human-like by moving and clicking the mouse slowly and not sending keyboard shortcuts too quickly. Now that I've documented the high-level task requirements, I need to make a simple blueprint to architect the project. For now, I'm planning to code this against the Windows PC version of the game, but I can fall back to the mobile version of the game or an emulator if needed. I'm going to code it on the Node.js platform using TypeScript as my programming language. This allows me to leverage a lot of open source APIs available on the NPM website. Most of these libraries are cross-platform, so hopefully if I need to switch to a different operating system, some of the code will still work. I found these open source libraries to help me code this project. Memory.js, which extracts programming variables out of the game while running. GraphicsMagic, which has various image processing functions, for example, to search for the location of a specific champion on the screen. TesseractOCR. Once letters or numbers are drawn on the screen, they're converted to a picture. Tesseract analyzes the pixels in an image to extract them back out. TensorFlow. This allows us to set up a neural network really easily. SQLite. This is a database. We'll use it to store training data. Robot.js. This will help us simulate user input when the AI needs to perform an action. We'll use all of these pieces together to build this project. If I were coding this for a business with a team of engineers, we'd break each piece down into smaller chunks and estimate the amount of work required to complete each task. A project manager would schedule the tasks on a calendar, prioritized by bottlenecks and high risks first. That would allow business owners to see a high-level overview of our progress. Each coder would be assigned a different task, but we'd collaborate to make sure the pieces fit together. Since I'm just coding this for myself for fun, I'm going to skip this step. That's a general overview of the project I'm attempting to build and my overall design process. In future videos, I'll go through step by step how I'm coding each piece so we can learn together. Let me know in the comments below if you have any suggestions on how I can improve my design, as well as your prediction on what competitive rank you think my bot can achieve.